For this lesson, you need to open the sample file Sales Analysis Chart 1 from your Sample Files folder. In the last lesson, you learned how to adjust page breaks in Normal View. That's the view you're seeing now. But many users also like to adjust page breaks in Page Layout View. Microsoft, however, recommends that you don't use either. There's a purpose-built view just to handle page breaks called Page Break Preview View. I'm now going to click the Page Break Preview View button at the bottom right of the screen. And when I do, Page Break Preview is displayed. Just like Normal View, Page Break Preview allows you to see which breaks are manual and which are automatic. Breaks shown as solid lines were manually inserted. Breaks shown as dotted lines were automatically inserted by Excel. Notice that your manually inserted vertical break to the left of column E is shown as a solid line, while Excel's automatic page break after row 49 is shown as a dotted line. Page Break Preview View allows you to click and drag page breaks, and that's something that you can't do with other views. I'm going to scroll down now so that I can see the automatic page break between rows 99 and 100. And I'm going to move that using click and drag so that the page breaks at the beginning of the November sales between rows 77 and 78. So I hover over the dotted line until I see the two-headed arrow cursor shape, and then click and drag upwards until the page break is located between rows 77 and 78. And when I release the mouse button, you can see that I now have a solid blue line, indicating that this horizontal page break was manually inserted. An interesting feature of Page Break Preview is its ability to scale a page to fit the paper. We did this manually in Lesson 7.4. But the process is far more intuitive in this view. I'm going to scroll down until I can see row 127. Notice that there's an automatic page break between rows 127 and 128. I'd like to show all of the November sales on the same page, so I'm going to drag this page break to a new position between rows 145 and 146. So I'll look for the two-headed arrow cursor shape, click and drag, and place the page break into its new position. Now you might have expected that Excel would have placed an automatic page break somewhere within page 3. But you can see it hasn't done that. And because there are now many more rows on page 3, the only way Excel can have achieved this is by scaling the page. Let's have a look at a print preview to prove that this has happened on page 3. So I click File on the ribbon, then Print on the left-hand menu bar, and I'll move to page 3 using the Next Page button. And you can see that page 3 does now contain all of November's sales. But you can also see that the font size has been greatly reduced. Now I'll click the Previous Page button to move back to page 2. And you can see that the font has also been reduced on page 2 and on page 1. Excel can't scale a single page in isolation. It scales all pages to keep the font size of all report pages consistent. I'll now click the Back button to return to the Page Break Preview view. Excel's automatic scaling system means that it's easy to lose track of what's happening. Sometimes you want to set everything back to the way it used to be and start again. I'll do that now by clicking Page Layout on the ribbon and in the Page Setup group, Breaks, and then I'll select Reset All Page Breaks. And when I do, you can see that those solid blue lines have now gone. And I'm left with dotted blue lines showing me only automatic page breaks. All that remains for this lesson is to save your work, and I'm going to save with the new name, Sales Analysis Chart 2. And as usual, I'll save to the folder above my sample files folder. I click the Save button, and you've now completed Lesson 7-6, Adjust Page Breaks Using Page Break Preview.